We learnt how to brush.
That you already know. I have taught you.
No, Mama. Dentists had come to our school. They taught us the correct way of brushing.
Kids, today we have with us special guest to teach you how to take care of your teeth.
Good morning, children. Today we'll be teaching you how to brush your teeth correctly. Please pay attention because we have some goodies for you.
First, let us do horizontal scrub technique.
First, place the bristles at 90 degrees to the tooth surface and use short horizontal strokes. Brush the back teeth, front, outside, inside, and also here.
Next, let's learn Fong's technique. This time we'll be brushing in circular motion. Go round and round like this.
Remember that these are only for children, so don't forget to do it twice daily at home.
I hope all of you will remember this thing. So, anyone wants to try?
Yes, Krishna, come.
This is the horizontal scrub technique, and this is the circular technique.
My teeth have become loose. Am I supposed to brush the same way?
I have braces. How should I brush?
Confused much about brushing techniques? What, when and how? We're going to clear this dilemma for you. For different oral problems, there are different brushing techniques. Let's see how each of them is done.
I will now show you a brushing technique which is called Bass technique. This technique is used for general population who do not have any periodontal disease or gum problem.
Take a soft or a medium bristle brush. Place the head of the soft brush parallel to the teeth so that the head of the brush covers 3 to 4 teeth, beginning from the last teeth, like this. Place the bristle at the gum region, establishing an angle of 45 degrees to long axis of the teeth. Then exert gentle vibratory pressure. Take short back and forth motions. Complete 20 strokes in same position. Same way, brush the whole mouth inside and outside. Like this.
Now I will explain you modified Bass technique. This technique is used for young adult patients with no periodontal problems.
A soft or medium bristled brush is placed on the last teeth of the arch, making an angle of 45 degrees to the sulcus, covering around 3 to 4 teeth. Exert gentle vibratory and back and forth motion. Complete 20 strokes in the same way and then move the brush along the tooth surface. Similarly, all the inner and outer sides of all the teeth are brushed.
Now, I am showing you about the modified Silman technique, which is used in patients with gingival recession.
A soft or medium bristle toothbrush is used. It is placed resting partly on the lower part of the teeth and partly on the gums, pointing in this direction at an oblique angle to the teeth. Apply pressure against the margins of the gums, then move the brush at about 20 back and forth strokes while simultaneously rolling it away from the gums and tooth surface. Similarly, this has to be done on the outer and inner surface of front and back teeth.
Chartres brushing technique, which is used for orthodontic patients, those who have undergone periodontal surgery, and patients with the fixed prosthesis.
The toothbrush should be placed at a 90 degree angle to the long axis of the teeth so that the bristles are gently forced between the teeth but do not rest on the gums. The brush is moved in several small rotatory motions so that the sides of the bristle are in contact with the gum margin. After two or three such motions, the brush is removed and replaced in the same area and the motions are repeated.
Today, I'll be talking about how to clean the dentures and keep it neat and clean.
In order to clean the dentures, all we need here is a toothbrush, a toothpaste and a clean bowl of water. Now with the toothbrush and toothpaste, we'll clean all the friable and visible food debris on the denture like this, in this manner. After we are done with the outer portion, now we'll go to the inner portion and we'll do the same. Now, once we are done, we'll clean it in fresh running water and then we'll immerse it in a clean bowl of water for overnight. Now, you're done, your denture are fresh and clean.
And now I'll be telling you about how to select a toothbrush. The parts of a toothbrush include the head, which consists of the bristles, the neck and the handle for easy holding. The toothbrushes are available in 4 different bristle sizes. The hard bristle toothbrushes are not recommended for use. The medium bristle toothbrushes are used by adults having normal healthy gums, whereas the soft and the ultra soft bristle toothbrushes are used by adults having bleeding gums and sensitivity, and as well as used in children. Select a toothbrush head size which easily fits into the mouth and covers 2 to 3 teeth at a time. The bristles must not have any jagged or sharp edges. Ideally, a toothbrush must be changed every 3 to 4 months. Do not share toothbrushes or keep them in same containers. If kept in same container, they must be separately kept so as to prevent any cross-infection.
Now I'll tell you about how to select a toothpaste. To select a toothpaste, you should select a toothpaste which contains fluoride in it. You should see for the IDSC which is present on the toothpaste. For children below 3 years of age, you should give them toothpaste a size of a smear, that is the size of a rice. Then for children between 3 to 6 years, you have to give them a pea size of toothpaste. Then above 3-6 years, you have to choose the toothpaste, full length of toothpaste. Then between tooth powder and toothpaste, you should always consider toothpaste, because tooth powder contains more abrasive particles which can abrade the tooth surface more easily.
What about power toothbrushes? Well, the mechanical action of the bristles removes plaque, whereas the vibratory action removes bacteria. The cost of this toothbrush is 750 to 5000 rupees. It is effective in all the age groups, especially those who are physically and mentally challenged, hospitalized patients and those with braces. There's another brush which is designed by Dr. Rishi Bhimani. The head is small, the bristles cover the curvature of the teeth, and the neck becomes flexible when placed in hot water to clean the inaccessible areas of the mouth.
I'm sure this was very informative to all of you. We need to take care of our teeth, and so we need to brush every day, twice a day, and we hope you brush the right way.